school. She was the cheerleading team. Now she's the house captain.
Of the red team.
Yeah, red team. So that's how we met. Same school, same team, but 1 year apart.
Mm-hmm.
I was from 5, she was from 4.
Yeah, from 4.
Oh, asked her out so many times. Sometimes you get like dizzy. And then one day we went out, that was the first day, somewhere in Ampang, Tamarinds. Yeah.
Oh, he claimed it was a 10th, but well, initially it's because we were young, right? I was in secondary school. So obviously your mindset is, you know, parents tell you, you're not allowed to date. And which was true, I was always busy, but he said that I never asked him to call back.
Yeah, there's no like, you call me back in half an hour, 1 hour. Oh, we had Thai food, tamarind spring roll, right?
Is it Thai food? It's not Thai food, it's
some kind of
Southeast
Asian cuisine.
Yeah, something. Yeah.
What exactly you ordered, I can't remember, but it was nice. It's very nicely lit up. It's got the lights on the pathway, very nice.
Was nice. And actually, I wasn't sure whether it was really a date. Though he gave me a flower at the end, or at the beginning, he gave me a flower, but I wasn't quite sure whether it was considered a date until like much later. He just said, "Oh, it's your birthday. You know, I want to take you out, celebrate your birthday."
Last year, so beginning of last year, then I was researching on rings. That particular day I was very free in London, so I thought I'll go walk around, look for some rings, and found the perfect ring. But I had to ask around and see whether that's exactly what she wanted. And we've really been planning a trip to Bali, so I thought this is a great time. I get the ring and then propose in Bali. So we planned it all out, but as usual, things don't go out as planned. When we went to Bali, I really planned out the itinerary, what we'll do, when, and hence I even packed my bags with the ring on planning to propose on the second day at a certain place. Because she normally helps me tidy up, so I had to hide the ring in my pants, which I will wear on the second day. And we arrived. I thought, alright, plans are all planned out, shouldn't be a problem. The guide told us, no, we can't do it in this sequence. You know, we can't drive from one mountain to another mountain directly, we've got to go down. So we can't do this in one day. I said, okay, in that case, then on this day, we should go to this place. And we did. And as we reached that place, the guide told us, oh, be careful, because the peddlers will try to sell you things. I was thinking, oh, now you tell us this. So we went there, took about 20 minutes to shake off all the peddlers, and we stood at Mount Batu, looking at Mount Batu, and I started going through what I rehearsed, my speech, what I'm going to say, and soon about 2 more lines to I proposed, it started raining. It rained, then we had to go in the shade. As soon as we went into the shade, we got attacked by all these peddlers. Do you want to buy this? Do you want to buy that? So the guide went up to get the umbrella. So I thought, okay, I've got like what, 5 minutes or so, get the peddlers away and propose.
And then his parents went along as well. So I told him, I said, why don't we follow your parents? I have my shawl, you know, we can just like cover ourselves and run across with them. He said, no, let's wait for the driver to come back with the umbrella.
I was really like trying to buy time and just get it done. Because after which I don't even know when's the next time I'm going to do it again, because the sound was a bit harder to get than I practiced. I guess all that movement. So, just in time, I asked, would you marry me? And then she said, yes. And I put the ring on. And just as the ring went on and it's done, the driver just arrived. And he asked, baru beli ka?
He thought he bought something from the peddlers.
So who she is, because everything she is nice, kind, understanding. She's always patient. Me, although sometimes I'm impatient. So she's the, in this case, definitely the better half. The nicer, better half.
I guess compatible, like we get along. And he's someone that I can see myself growing old with, having kids, and yeah, just growing old, like you know, those old lefty couples, like me up.